Hello friends, welcome to Knowledge Stream. Friends, in this lecture series, we will discuss about the Governor General and Viceroy of British period, and we will also discuss some important event occurred during their rule. But in the first part, we will cover only Governor General, whose tenure was from 1773 to 1858, and this post of Governor General was changed to Viceroy in Government of India Act 1958. So in this lecture series, the first period was between 1773 to 1857. First such Governor General was Warren Hastings, whose tenure was from 1773 to 1785. Some of the important events occur under their rule was as follows. Number one, Regulating Act 1773 was passed during his tenure, and it designated Governor of Bengal, which is also known as Governor of Fort William, to the Governor General of Bengal, and it also provided an executive council of four members to assist Governor General. And first such Governor General was Lord Warren Hastings, whose tenure was from 1773 to 1785. Regulating Act of 1773 also provided for the establishment of Supreme Court here at Calcutta, and it was established on 1774, whose component was one Chief Justice and three other judges. And in his tenure, basically Rohilla War was fought, which fought on 1774. Next important event under his tenure was British Parliament passed Amendment Act of 1781, which is also 1781, which is also known as Act of Settlement. So, Act of Settlement was passed on 1781. Next is First Maratha War, which was fought between 1775 to 1782, and First Maratha War was ended under the Treaty of Salbai, which was signed on 1782. Next important event was Second Mysore War. The period was between 1782-84, and this second Mysore War was ended with Treaty of Mangalore. Friends, as we know that first Mysore War was fought between 1767 to 1769, and in this war Hyder Ali was the winner, and in the second Mysore War 1780-1784, Hyder Ali was dead due to cancer in 1782. And a Treaty of Mangalore finally was signed between Tipu Sultan and Warren Hastings. Under his rule, Pitt's India Act was passed on 1784, which divided the function of a company into two parts. Administrative function is covered by the Court of Director, and the its commercial function was covered by the Board of Control. And one important event occurred in his tenure was Asiatic Society of Bengal, whose foundation was laid on 1784. Some of other important event under his tenure was because of strained relationship with Chet Singh, who was Maharaja of Banaras, and because of conspiracy against Nand Kumar. Nand Kumar was influential official of Bengal. Because of these two reasons, Hastings was imprisoned in England. And it is also known that Warren Hastings and Sir Elijah Impey, who was the first Chief Justice of Supreme Court, was the main conspirator behind the Nand Kumar. So these two reasons, because of restrained relationship with Chet Singh and conspiracy against Nand Kumar, led to the impeachment of Warren Hastings in England. In 1785, Warren Hastings basically returned to England, and on his return, he was impeached by House of Commons for alleged oppression and corruption. A main point basically were accused of oppression in Rohilla War, okay, oppression and deposing Chet Singh of Banaras and accepting bribe, and general corruption in the company. And this basically impeachment was proceeded by Edmund Burke in England. So, friends, we have discussed first Governor General, whose tenure was from 1773 to 1785, and we also discussed some of the important events during his tenure. And next Governor General now is Lord Cornwallis, whose tenure was from 1786 to 1793, and his first tenure was, we have already discussed, 1786 to 1793. But before the arrival of Cornwallis, there was John McPherson, who served as acting Governor General of India. For the second time, he came to India in 1805 as a Governor General, but he died very early. Lord Cornwallis was famous for permanent settlement of Bengal, which was he founded on 1793, and with the help of Sir John Soar and James Grant. This permanent settlement of Bengal 1793 is a 10-year settlement system, which was against annual lease system, which was introduced by the first Governor General of India, Warren Hastings, and which were the reason where this permanent settlement of Bengal was applied. First one is Bengal, second one is Bihar, third one is Banaras, fourth one is Odisha, and fifth one is Karnataka. So these are were the reason where this permanent settlement of Bengal 1793 was applied. Friends, as we know about the Cornwallis, that he is known by the person of incorporating several judicial reform, which is known by the name of Cornwallis Code. And Cornwallis Code was came in basically 1793, and main purpose of this Cornwallis Code was separation of revenue administration and civil jurisdiction. And one thing that Cornwallis brought is Europeanization of the administrative machinery and introduction of the civil service in India. He is also famous for introduction of police, basically modernization of police service in India. During his tenure, Third Mysore War, whose tenure was from 1792, and which was ended with Treaty of Srirangapatnam, which was signed in 1792. In this war, Third Mysore War, Tipu Sultan was defeated, and he was forced to sign Treaty of Srirangapatnam. So, by the Treaty of Srirangapatnam, Third Mysore War ended. And Third Mysore War occurred between 1792. As we have discussed that Cornwallis was first Governor General who died in India during his second tenure, and he came to India 1805 in his second tenure. And we discuss about the policy of Cornwallis, that he stick to the policy of naturality as against the expansionist policy of Warren Hastings. Warren Hastings basically employed expansionist policy. Next Governor General was third, Sir John Soar, whose tenure was from 1793 to 1798. During his tenure, important events were Charter Act of 1793, and most important event under his tenure was that expense, salary, interest and dividend were borne by the Indian Exchequer. And under his tenure also, separation of revenue and judicial function occur. And next important event because of this is that disappearing of Mal Adalat. Friends, the Battle of Kharda, which was fought between Nizam and Maratha, occurred in 1795 under the tenure of Sir John Soar. Let me discuss about the policy of Sir John Soar. He adopted policy of non-intervention. These are the, some important events under his tenure, and his tenure was from 1793 to 1798, Sir John Soar. Next Governor General was Lord Wellesley, number 4, whose tenure was from 1798 to 1805. And some of the important events or steps taken by the Lord Wellesley are as follows. Lord Wellesley was a great imperialist, and he called himself Bengal Tiger. Basically, he came to India with the aim that he convert British Empire India to British Empire of India, and he is very famous for introduction of subsidiary alliance. He introduced subsidiary alliance in year 1798. Basically, it was new, not a new system. Originally, this idea of duplex French Governor of General of India. So, subsidiary alliance system was not a new idea, and First, it was introduced by the Dupleix, French Governor General, who was French Governor General. And who were the state which first entered into subsidiary alliance system, which was introduced in 1798? The first one is Nizam of Hyderabad in 1798. Second one was Tanjore in 1799. Third one was Surat in 1800. Fourth one was Awadh in 1801. And the fifth one was Carnatic in 1801. So these were the states who entered into a subsidiary alliance system just after the introduction of it by the Lord Wellesley. During his tenure, some of the important event was passing of Censorship Act 1799. Basically, purpose was to stop French from publishing that could harm British Empire in India. So, if the question came, what is the purpose of Censorship Press Act 1799 was to stop French from publishing that could harm British. And for the training of the civil servant, he formed Fort William College in Bengal in 1800. During his tenure, 4th Anglo-Mysore Wars were fought between English and Tipu Sultan. And in this war, Tipu Sultan was died, and this war was ended in 1799. And under his tenure, one important event which occurred is 2nd Maratha War, whose tenure was from 1803 to 1805. So these are the some important events which occurred under the rule of Lord Wellesley, 4th Governor General, and whose tenure was from 1798 to 1805. Next Governor General, 5th, was Sir George Barlow, whose tenure was from 1805 to 1807. And under his tenure, a Vellore Mutiny was occurred in 1806. Basically, main reason of Vellore Mutiny 1806 was to interference in the custom and culture of Indian sepoy. And basically, there were Commander-in-Chief of Madras, Sir John Cradock, and Lord Howden, who basically passes this regulation to regulate the dress of sepoy. So, Vellore Mutiny occurred to regulate the dress of sepoy, and which introduced by the Sir John Cradock and Lord Howden, who was Commander-in-Chief of Madras. So this is the 5th Governor General of India, Sir John Barlow, whose tenure was from 1805 to 1807. Next Governor General, number 6, Lord Minto, whose tenure was from 1807 to 1813. During his tenure, Treaty of Amritsar was signed with Ranjit Singh in 1809. Let me talk about Maharaja Ranjit Singh, who consolidated 12 measles into Khalsa state. What is a measles? Measles is a large tract of land in Punjab, and holder of this large tract of land is known as Measledar. Under his tenure, basically Lord Minto, 1807 to 1813, Charter Act 1813 was passed, and main point of Charter Act was that it ended the monopoly of East India Company, and but trade with China and trade in tea with India was retained. The second important point in this Charter Act was allowed Christian missionary to propagate their religion. And also, it was said in this Charter Act 1813 that company would invest 1 lakh per year on education. So these three are the important points into the Charter Act of 1813. Next Governor General was 7th Lord Hastings, whose tenure was from 1813 to 1823. And friend, Lord Hastings was also known as Lord Moria. His tenure was known as Policy of Intervention and War. Let me discuss most important event during his tenure was Anglo-Nepal War, which was fought between 1814 to 16, and Anglo-Nepal War was ended with the Treaty of Sagauli, which was signed in 1816. Next important event was Third Maratha War. Tenure was from 1817 to 19, and after this war there was dissolution of Maratha Confederacy, and during his tenure this war Peshwa was Bajirao II, whose tenure was from 1798 to 1818, and after this war Bombay Presidency was created in 1818. Another standard one important event was strife with Pindari, 1817 to 1818. Basically, Pindari was not a permanent soldier of basically Maratha. Their main purpose was to loot after the war. Friends, Lord Hastings, whose tenure was from 1813 to 1823, are also known for the implement of Roith Wire system during his tenure. And Roith Wire system was introduced by Thomas Munro, who was governor of Madras. And Thomas Munro introduced this Roith Wire system during the tenure of Lord Hastings with the help of Charles Reed. And he introduced Roith Wire system on 1820. Roith Wire system basically practiced in the region. First one is Bombay, Madras, Assam, Burma, and Coorg. Next important event which occurred under his rule is abolition of censorship, which was imposed in 1799 by the Lord Wellesley to stop the French from publishing anything which could harm British Empire in India. In 1818, India's first vernacular newspaper, Samachar Darpan, was started after abolition of censorship. So, these are the important events which occur under the rule of Lord Hastings, whose tenure was from 1813 to 1823. Next Governor General was Lord Amherst, whose tenure was from 1823 to 1828. He was known during his tenure. Basically, Barrackpore Mutiny 1824 was occurred, and it is also a result of interference on Indian social custom by the British. In his tenure, Lord Amherst, first Burmese war fought between 1824 to 1826, and this war, first Burmese war, ended with the Treaty of Yandabo, and this treaty was signed on 1826. Next Governor General was 9, Lord William Bentinck, whose tenure was from 1828 to 1835. Let me talk about the policy of Lord William Bentinck. He adopted policy of non-intervention and non-aggression. Lord William Bentinck was known for the eradication of the social evil which were basically spread in the Indian society at that time. He abolished sati and other cruel rites in 1829 by the regulation of Savin. The practice of sati basically first banned in Goa by the Portuguese. He also suppressed the thug in 1830 with the help of named Sir William Sleeman. So that the William Sleeman is known by the name of Thuggee Sleeman because of his much more action against the thug. During the tenure of Lord William Bentinck, whose tenure was from 1828 to 1835, Charter Act of 1833, or which is also known by the name of St. Helena Act, was passed, which made the Governor General of Bengal to the Governor General of India, and first such Governor General of India was Lord William Bentinck. Basically, he ended the monopoly over the trade with China and trade in tea with India. Charter Act 1833 ended the monopoly of East India Company over trade with China and trade in tea with India. Resolution of 1835 and educational reform was occurred under the tenure of Lord William Bentinck, and English as an official language was introduced during his tenure. He was also famous known for perpetual friendship treaty with Ranjit Singh. He abolished the provincial court of appeal and circuit, which was set up by Cornwallis, and appointment of commissioner of revenue and circuit in place of appeal and circuit. He also shifted the headquarters of Sadar Diwani Adalat and Sadar Nizamat Adalat in Allahabad. And during his tenure, important event occurred is Law Commission, which was set up under Thomas Babington Macaulay, which is most famously known as Lord Macaulay, for codification of Indian law, and this commission was set up on 1833. Next Governor General was Lord Metcalfe, 10, whose tenure was from 1835 to 1836, and a new press law was passed under his tenure, which remove restriction of press of India. So Lord Metcalfe is known by the name of liberator of Indian press. His tenure was too short. Next important Governor General was 11, Lord Auckland, whose tenure was from 1836 to 1842. During his tenure, First Afghan War, which was fought between 1838 to 1842, was fought, and he is also known as most unsuccessful Governor General of India because of his policy against the Afghan. And in his tenure, death of Ranjit Singh occurred on 1839. One important event occurred during his tenure was in 1837, last Mughal Emperor of India, Bahadur Shah Jafar, who wrote Ghazal and Shayari with the pet name of Jafar, sat on the throne of Mughal Empire, and he was also the son of Akbar II. So this is the 11th Governor General, Lord Auckland, and whose tenure was from 1836 to 1842, and these are the some important events which occurred during his tenure. Next Governor General was Lord Edinburgh, whose tenure was from 1842 to 1844, and most important event occurred during his tenure was annexation of Sindh, which annexed in 1843. So he is best known for the annexation of Sindh. During his tenure, war with Gwalior was fought in 1843, same year, and most important event which occurred in his tenure in 1843 is end of slavery. During his reign, name of the last Mughal emperor, which we have discussed earlier, that Bahadur Shah Jafar, was removed from the coin. This is the important event occurred during his tenure. Next Governor General, 13, Lord Hardinge, whose tenure was from 1844 to 1848. During his tenure, some of the important event occurred is First Anglo-Sikh War, which was fought between 1845 to 1846, and Treaty of Lahore, which was signed on 1846. Let me know about the successor of Maharaja Ranjit Singh, who died on 1839. First successor was Khadak Singh, second was Nihal Singh, and after that Dilip Singh sat on the throne, who were only 7 years old, and with the regent of Jind Kaur, who was his mother. And Treaty of Lahore was signed between Maharaja Dilip Singh and Lord Hardinge. Some of the social reforms in during his tenure was abolition of female infanticide and human sacrifice. So these are the some important events which occurred under the rule of Lord Hardinge, whose tenure was from 1844 to 1848. Next Governor General, 14, Lord Dalhousie, whose tenure was from 1848 to 1856. He is best known by the name Maker of Modern India. Let me discuss about some important event or some important step taken by the Lord Dalhousie. Lord Dalhousie, also known by the name of James Andrew Ramsay, he was youngest Governor General of India, and during his tenure, Second Anglo-Sikh War was fought, who fought between 1848 and 49, and finally Punjab was annexed into the British India, and it was annexed in 1849. During his tenure, annexation of Lower Burma and Pegu was occur in 1852. He is famous for the introduction of doctrine of lapse. In this basically doctrine was that if the king died without natural heir, then the state will be annexed by the British. And under his rule, some of the important state which were annexed is, first one is Satara, which was annexed in 1848, Jaitpur and Sambalpur 1849, Bhagat 1850, Udaipur 1852, Jhansi 1853, Nagpur 1854, and Awadh 1856. So these are the some important states which basically annexed by the Dalhousie under the doctrine of lapse. During his tenure, Charles Wood Dispatch came to India, who was president of Board of Control, and this Charles Wood Dispatch came to India on 1854. Basically, he opened the Anglo Vernacular School and government colleges in India. During his tenure, Railway Minute of 1853 was passed, and first railway line between Bombay's Boribandar and Thane was laid in 1853. In this railway, basically there were three locomotive whose name were Sindh, Sultan and Sahib, and this journey was only 75 minutes between Bombay's Boribandar and Thane. Let me discuss one important event that in the world first railway line was laid on 1825 in England, and it connected between Stockton and Darlington. In standard telegraph was laid, it is a 4000 mile sub telegraph line which connected Calcutta with Bombay and Madras with Peshawar, and Postal Office Act 1854 was passed during his tenure. During his tenure, some important event which occur is opening of Ganga Canal, which was opened in 1854 for the irrigation of agriculture land, and he also established a separate public work department in every province. And some important social reform is Widow Remarriage Act, which was passed on 1856. Last Governor General in the series is 15 Lord Canning, whose tenure was from 1856 to 1857, and the post of Governor General was changed to Viceroy after the Government of India Act, and revolt of 1857 occurred under his rule, and important event occurred under his rule is establishment of three university at Calcutta, Madras and Bombay, which was established in 1857. So friends, these were the Governor Generals and some of important events during his tenures we have discussed. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the Viceroy and some of the important events during his tenure. Please subscribe our channel, please press bell button so that whenever a new video will upload, it will automatically inform you about the uploading of the video. Please subscribe our channel. Thank you very much.